Hello and welcome to the series of dynamic array functions in Excel. In this video, we will be discussing the sort formula in Excel, which is a powerful tool for sorting data in a spreadsheet. This we will learn in detail through the following steps. First, what is a sort formula and how does it differ from sort function or tool? Second, understand the sort formula syntax. Third, a detailed explanation with examples. Fourth, sorting data by columns and rows. Fifth, sorting data with multiple columns. And sixth, benefits of using sort formula with table. So first, what is a sort formula and how does it differ from sort function or tool? The sort formula in Excel is a function that allows you to sort data in a specified range or array. It can be used to sort data based on a single column or multiple columns, as well as by ascending or descending order. Sorting is an essential function for anyone working with data in Excel, and it can save a lot of time and effort when you need to organize large sets of data. In Excel, the sort function and the sort formula are two different ways of sorting data. The sort function is a built-in function in Excel for sorting data, while the sort formula is a dynamic array formula in Excel for sorting data. The sort function is a quick and easy method of sorting data. However, the sort formula can be more complex to use and require more time to set up. The sort function sorts the data in place and permanently changes the original data, whereas the sort formula doesn't change the original data. The sort function is not suitable for complex sorting rules, whereas the sort formula is often used to create complex sorting rules. Now let's go to Excel to understand the sort formula syntax. In Excel, it can be found in the Formulas tab, in the Function Library, under the lookup and reference group. You can access it by clicking on it. Or simply type equal to, sort, open parenthesis, and you will see the sort formula syntax. It includes four arguments, out of which the first, that is array, is only required arguments, while other three are an optional argument, since they are enclosed in square brackets. To understand it better, let's click on this function sign, and it will open a dialog box, Function Arguments. Here, the array is bolded, which indicates that it is required arguments, while others are in a normal format, which indicates that these are optional arguments. Array refers to the range of cells that you want to sort. Sort underscore index specifies the column number or index that you want to sort by. Sort underscore order determines whether you want to sort the data in ascending or descending order. We can use 1 for sort in ascending order, and -1 for descending order. By underscore col is a logical value that determines whether you want to sort by row or column. To sort by row, use 0 or false, and for column, use 1 or true. Not to worry if you don't fully understand the syntax. We'll explain with examples. As an example, let's select this range as the array argument and click OK. As you can see, the dates are sorted in ascending order. Let's expand the range to the column, and we can see the same data reflected here with sorted by a date column. Now, let's understand the second argument, which is sort underscore index, and is used to specify the column number or index you want to sort by. As a default, it is assumed to be 1, and the range will be sorted according to the first column. For example, if we add 1 here and accept the changes, the result will remain the same. However, if we change it to 2, the range will be sorted by the second column, that is product. Likewise for 3, by the unit price column. For the third argument, which is sort underscore order, it will, by default, sort by ascending order, and its value is 1. Therefore, even if you skip it, the result will be the same. But if you wish to sort it in descending order, use minus 1, like this. As we can see, the dates are sorted in descending order with the larger date on top. To better understand sorting by rows and columns, let's refer to this range. First, we will add the sort formula to this range, and it will sort the data by the first column. In order to understand the fourth argument, let's skip the second and third arguments, and it will take a default value for it. As we can see here, when we write true or 1, it sorts by column, and when we write false or 0, it sorts by row. By default, the value is false or 0. Therefore, if we write 0, the result will be the same. But, let's see what happens if we change it to 1. The data is sorted by column. Similarly, you can try adding sort underscore index to the formula and see how it works. Now, let's return to the earlier sheet in order to understand how to sort data with multiple columns. To keep the sort ascending, let's remove the minus 1. The data is now sorted by the date column, and there are multiple products on the same date. In this case, we might want to sort the data first by date and then by product. Like product 6 on top, then product 8, and then product 9. This can be done using a curly bracket in the formula for the sort underscore index argument. Like this. We can see here that, first, it is sorted by date, then by product. Here, 1, 2 is the array of sort indices, which sorts the data first by column 1, date, and then by column 2, product. Furthermore, if there are multiple values for a product on the same date, you can add a third criterion to sort by. Like, sort this in ascending order. For this, we can add a third index to the sort underscore index argument for the unit price. And we can see it is also sorted accordingly. Now for each column, in the same way, we can also specify the sort order, like ascending or descending. Let's add that to the formula. The array specifies that the date column will be sorted in ascending order, the product column will be sorted in descending order, and the unit price column will be sorted in ascending order. Let's see the results. Using different conditions, you can check the results. This is how the data can be sorted by multiple columns. Now let's understand the benefits of using a sort formula with a table. When using sort with a range, the formula will only sort the cells within that specific range. If you add new data to the sheet outside of the range, the sort formula will not include it in the sorted output. Let's add one entry below, and we can see that it is not part of the sort range. So whenever you add a new entry, you have to update the sort formula range accordingly. However, when using sort with a table, the formula will automatically include any new rows that are added to the table. This means that you don't need to update the formula every time you add new data to the table. In order to check it, let's turn this range into a table. Now let's update the sort formula. You can see that the table name appears when we select the entire range. As we add new data to the table, the sort range automatically updates. It will be updated even if you delete an entry. Hope you find this video helpful and informative. Watch out for the next video. Thanks for watching.